good moves coming in for the global markets as well, especially Wall Street, because you know, S&P and Nasdaq have notched fresh highs. So good stuff going on, at least on Wall Street. So take us through what's been happening over there.
Well, absolutely, and it's very interesting what we're seeing play out with the Wall Street, because right now on futures you're not seeing much of a move there, but then of course for Wall Street you did have quite the interesting moves coming in. So let's take a quick look at what we really saw happening. Of course, this is a data heavy week, so that is also something that we're watching out for. But when you look at stock futures, you're looking at them inching down just a little bit, and that is of course as this is of course the lead up to June's Federal Reserve policy meeting as well. Now of course a muted but notable day, because S&P 500 and Nasdaq, like you mentioned Snehi, rose modestly to notch new record closes. When you look at Dow, then that inched higher by nearly about 0.2%, and this comes as traders prepare for the two-day Fed policy meeting as well, and all eyes are definitely going to be on that, because the meeting will be concluding on Wednesday. This is of course a meeting that everybody has been keeping an eye on, and this of course has an interest rate policy decision and a subsequent press conference featuring Jerome Powell, and whatever his commentary is extremely important then. And let's also take a look at what else investors are waiting for. Now of course the meeting also has investors anxiously awaiting the policy announcement, but then largely pricing in that the borrowing rate remains unchanged. Now, when you look at Fed funds futures, they were indicating virtually no chance of a cut at this week's meeting, according to CME's FedWatch tool. Before the Fed decision, investors will also be analyzing small business data due out Tuesday. Like I mentioned, a little bit of a data-heavy week with a couple of important data sets coming in. So the second one, and the second piece in this puzzle will be the consumer price index reading for May expected in the morning on Wednesday. And on the corporate earnings front, then you have Oracle reporting its numbers, as well as Rubrik that is slated for after the bell on Tuesday. So that is key to watch. Now, of course, in Europe, we did see quite the potboiler sort of play out, and European stocks closed lower, and no points for guessing that, because you did have that announcement coming in for Snap elections. And that of course indicates that there's a little bit of political uncertainty there, and that of course is something that we saw both in DAX as well as CAC. So when you take a look at what the DAX did, you're looking at declines of about 0.3% coming in for DAX, and when you look at CAC as well, similar moves coming in there as well. So very important to see how it really pans out for Europe then, Snehi.
Absolutely.
If you like this video, then like, share and subscribe to ET Now.